Hello, I'm Dr. Orit Kent, and I'm one of the co-founders and co-directors of the Pedagogy of Partnership. POP is a research-based Jewish educational model focused on relationship building. We teach a set of attitudes and skills to strengthen how we engage in relationship building, learning, and meaningful conversations with others. I'm here today to share with you about one of POP's core relational frameworks. Within Jewish tradition, we have a deep sensibility that learning happens in relationship with others. We bring you these quotes as some examples. And that when people come together as study companions and truly listen to one another, Torah is received, renewed, and not only that, but that God, God's self, listens. This ideal that learning is rooted in relationship is thrown into stark relief by our current circumstances of physical and social distancing, a time when being in relationship is made difficult and the need for it is therefore ever clearer to us. In education, moving to online learning has laid bare the work we need to do as educators to be intentional about how to create relationships between ourselves and our learners, and significantly so between our learners and their peers, as our youth ache for connection with friends. Now, our work is not only a matter of enacting Jewish wisdom or what we know from research to be excellent education, but relational learning is now a matter of mental health and well-being. This partnership framework is one of our foundational frameworks and serves to guide us in our relationship building work as educators. It grows out of university-based research we did where we studied the microcosm of chavruta, a traditional mode of learning where two people study a text together, to better understand the forces that help make learning a holistic and relationship-centered endeavor. While people learning through POP are certainly not learning in chavruta or in pairs all the time, the chavruta framework represents a powerful atomic structure for understanding how we connect, learn, and talk together, whether in pairs, in full groups, or as we walk through our lives. There are a few things I want to point out in this diagram. Number one, this triangle helps us see each individual learner. And it's our job as educators to invite each individual person into the room as fully as we can. And then begins the work of supporting our learners to not only connect with us, but with each other, and to help them understand that each person has the ability to bring something of value to the partnership. Number two, partnership learning is not just about people learning together. There is a third partner in this diagram, and that is the text or content. And as a partner, the text has its own voice that we need to honor. It's important to say that the text in this diagram can be any meaningful third thing having to do with your content, focus, or theme. It can be a song, a picture, a movie, a story we share about an experience, or it can be an actual written text. Number three, when we study with a human partner and a text, each of the partners, texts and people, affect the other, generating understandings and insights that emerge from these particular sets of relationships. Number four, the partnerships that we share among people and texts call upon our intellectual and social-emotional capacities, and these capacities are not separate but intertwined. And number five, this triangle, which purposefully does not feature the educator, not because educators don't have a huge role to play in supporting and scaffolding these triangles to take shape, but because we want to highlight our core job as educators, to guide and empower our learners to build their own relationships with each other and Torah or other rich content. Very practically, this entails helping our learners use this triangle to monitor their own learning. For example, some students like to picture this triangle like a triangular air hockey table. They see their job as returning the constantly moving imaginary hockey puck to the middle of the triangle, because that's where all partners connect and are in balance. They try to notice if the hockey puck is too far in one corner of the triangle, and when that happens, they adjust what they are doing to bring in their other learning partners. Our role as educators is to help these triangles take shape and to model these ways of connecting in how we interact with our learners. So what we are aiming for is to create a culture and community of learning built out of the strength of many triangles in relationship to each other. When we think about how we design lessons and educational experiences, it's important that we think about all parts of the triangle and ask ourselves these questions. How am I inviting in and helping each individual learner to be present? How am I connecting learners to one another? How am I inviting in and helping the text to be present and available for partnership? How am I connecting learners and text to one another? And how am I helping them to do this for themselves over time? Our online teaching page has a variety of activities that can help you build these lines of connections and help your students do the same. We have warm-up and advisory activities that help you build connections to individual learners and help learners build connections to one another. The text learning activities support learners to build connections to their content and to their peers. And finally, the reflection activities help learners learn from their experiences so that they can get better at building these lines of connection over time. I want to thank all of you, teachers and educators, for working your hearts out to provide your students with community, care, and learning during these challenging times. Thanks for popping by.